No knowledge would lead us to the noses of Allah's attributes. No knowledge would lead us to the friendship of Almighty Allah. And no knowledge and science would lead us to the divine world unless we get rid of the grip and control of nafs. Nafs has many attractions and deceptions to detract us. And we are always indulged, involved, engaged in these deceptions. And this independence and freedom of nafs comes, first of all, through the link with a suhbah, link with some pious company, link with shaykh. It doesn't mean just to make bay'ah with the hands. It is not compulsory. Put hands in hands is a recommended way, but it is not mandatory, it is not imperative, it is not compulsory. This is unanimous view. This is a way of declaration of your loyalty. The basic thing is your intention, your irada, your niyya, your decision of your heart, decision of your mind, decision of your being attached with some company. Because the spiritual pious company is the actual fountain of hidayah. And then this company and attachment, only company and attachment, is never, never, never sufficient for you and beneficial for you unless you put yourself in riyada. As-suhba and then riyada, the struggle for purification of nafs. First is suhba, and suhba is with three things. There would be no company. No company is acceptable, accepted as company. No suhba would be accepted as suhba. And no suhba would be beneficial and useful as a suhba. Unless the suhba, the company, fulfills three conditions. First, love of whom you are the company with. Loving him, following him, serving him. Love, following and serving. And the best sohbah in this universe is the sohbah of Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, either directly or through someone. This is the ultimate sohbah which everybody wants to get, and everybody should make its objective. Either directly or through somebody. Because to get suhbah and connection with Holy Prophet through somebody, this is the chain. This is the chain. How you get connected with one by one, up to Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And suhbah is with following. If you don't follow, so there is no suhbah. If you don't love those who are beloved of Almighty Allah, love for sake of Allah, there is no suhbah. And if you're not in their khidmah, there is no suhbah. So this is the suhbah, the company. But only suhbah and company would never be useful and beneficial. I mean decisively useful and decisively beneficial, although it has its own benefits. It won't be decisively useful unless you accompany this company with riyada, tazkiyah. The process of purification, the endeavors, the efforts, spiritual efforts. If you don't start sitting on musalla during nights, if you not start sleeplessness in your life, if you keep on sleeping, and if you keep on eating, and if you keep on speaking, then it means all fountains of divinity are closed in your nafs, closed in your heart. With suhbah, you have to do certain efforts. Al-riyada, al-tazkiyah, al-ihsan, al-mujahada. Only with mujahada, you get muraqabah, you get mulahaza. And then you get mushahada. And then you get mukhataba. And then you get mushafaha. These are outcomes. No soba would be beneficial totally unless you combine the riyada, your efforts in ta'a of Almighty Allah, in obedience of Almighty Allah, in worship of Almighty Allah, in love of Almighty Allah, in your efforts in zuhd, in abstinence for Almighty Allah, protecting yourself from every haram, living a life of halal, living a life in the following of the Sunnah of Holy Prophet, working according to the Sunnah of Holy Prophet, working according to the Seerah of Holy Prophet, walking in the footsteps of Holy Prophet. Unless you achieve the ittiba, unless you achieve ta'atul nabi, unless you achieve the connection with Holy Prophet, you act upon the teachings of Holy Prophet, you get nothing from soba. And then more and more efforts and endeavors you make in following, the more noor, the more qurb, the more nearness, the more blessing you get. That's why the people who got everything, they used to pray the Salatul Fajr with wuzu of Isha for 40 years in their life. This was Imam Azam Abu Hanifa. Many of Tabi'een, many Taba Tabi'een, many Awliya. The life of Imam Malik, the life of Imam Shafi'i, the life of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, the life of great Tabi'een of that time, the light of great Imams, the life of Junaid al-Baghdadi, the life of Bishr al-Hafi, the life of Sari al-Saqati, the light of Aimma of Ahlul Bayt, the life of Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra. She used to prostrate till the Fajr time arrived. And she gets up from her prostration, from her sujood, and asks, O Almighty Allah, in the winter when the nights are very long, very big, she says, you have made so short nights that I can't make a full, just one sajda for you. The life of Imam Bukhari, the life of Imam Muslim, the life of Sayyidina Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, the life of Sheikh Suhrawardi, the life of Imam Shazili, Ridwanullah Ta'ala alayhi majmain, everybody, Allama Iqbal says, kuch haath nahi aata be ahe sahar gahi. Unless you cry in the last hours of the night, unless you cry in the darkness, this is the best time when you come on Musalla, when everybody is sleeping. Then Almighty Allah comes on the first heaven. He himself asks, is there anybody to ask me? I am ready to give. Is there anybody to forgive, to ask for my pardon? I am here to forgive him. Is there anybody to raise hands in front of me? I am ready to fold his hands. So here you are connected with Almighty Allah through ta'ah, through ibadah, through sujood, through purity, through zuhud, through wara. Then you get the reality of iman. Then your heart is full of noor. Then you are a bashar, but better than a malak. You walk on the face of earth, but you are praised in the heavens. You are praised in the heavens. Almighty Allah then mention you in the company of angels. And Almighty Allah asks his angels, have you seen my dead person? How beautiful worshipper, how beautiful lover is he? Almighty Allah himself asks his angels. And in Sahih Muslim, he calls Jibreel alayhi salam. And Almighty Allah then says, O Jibreel, you know that particular person who lives in that town? Almighty Allah names someone. Hadith is Sahih in Muslim. Jibreel Amin says, yes, Almighty Allah, I know him. What do you want me to do for him? Almighty Allah says, I just want to inform you that I love him. We have never tasted the love of Almighty Allah. And what would be the position of those people who are loved by Almighty Allah? We have never thought of becoming lover of Allah. And there are the people who are beloved by Almighty Allah. Almighty Allah says to Jibreel, you know that person? Yes, oh my Lord, I know him. He says, just I want to tell you, I love him. Allahu Akbar. Inni yuhibbu. Just I love him. Who is saying these words? Allah says, I love him. What does it mean? Allah becomes lover of his own servant. This is how Quran explains, yuhibbuhum wa yuhibbunahu. There are some people, yuhibbunahu, those who love Almighty Allah. And there are some people, yuhibbuhum, that Allah himself loves them. Some are the lovers of Allah and some are the beloveds of Almighty Allah. So Almighty Allah reveals this thing to Jibreel that I love him. Then Jibreel asks, then what should I do? What I am supposed to do? So Almighty Allah says, Jibreel, if you are my true servant, I also want you to love him. This is the response. This is the return of love. I want you to love him. Jibreel Amin says, Almighty Allah, you be witness. I also love him because you love him. So this is the place where story of love starts from. Jibreel says, I also love him. Then Jibreel Amin asked Almighty Allah, what I am supposed further to do? Almighty Allah says, go in the heavens and announce my love in front of all angels. Tell them that I love that person. Oh my Allah, then what is there any specific commandment for them to accept this announcement? Almighty Allah says, yes, there is a commandment for them to announce there in the heavens that I love that particular person on the earth, and all angels of this heaven should also love him. So that person becomes Mahbubullah, then he becomes Mahbub Jibreel, then he becomes Mahbubul Malaika. So Jibreel Amin comes and announce, Yunadi fis sama, Inna Allaha yuhibbu fulanan fahibbuhu, fa yuhibbuhu ahlus sama. He makes an announcement that Almighty Allah loves him, that person. I also love him. And Allah wants all of you to love him too. For yuhibbuhu ahlus sama. Then Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, then all angels of the divine world start loving him. This is how that beloved of Almighty Allah becomes beloved of the whole divine world. ثُمَّ يُوْدَعُ لَهُ الْقُبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And then it is stated to the angels, oh angels, you go down to the world. And then the love of that particular person is laid down in the earth, laid down in this world, in the hearts of people. So this love with the of the beloved people, the pious people, the people who are Ahlul Zuhud, the people who left the love of the world for the sake of Allah's love, the people who accepted unrestness to get rest in love of Almighty Allah, the people who became sleepless for the sake of company of Almighty Allah,